Hello everyone, welcome back to our ICT class and this is video number 33. Hope you all are fine and safe. Did you study the topics which we have discussed previously in the last class? I hope it is so.
We have done an activity of calculating the day and night of a particular region in different months. We have done that activity and also that activity where it was those who are having computers practice those activity. I hope it is so. In under let's evaluate portion of the page number 76, we have done the first activity of calculating the time of sunrise on December 21st in Moscow and Sydney using the sun clock software, and we have done that activity. I hope you understood how to do. And what we have done next, we have moved to another topic, earth surface or maps. We have familiarized about different types of maps. We all know about the most popular map which we are using frequently is known as Google map. These all maps comes under the digital maps. OpenStreetMap, Wikimapia, Google maps, they all are the digital maps. So we have discussed about that. We saw different types of maps. We opened up this Wikimapia. We found how to locate different places. And also when we opened the map, what all things we have noticed? We have noticed places, roads, different place locations like schools, different places, different details we saw that was marked on that Wikimapia. And also we saw different layers on that map, which includes Wikimapia satellite, Google map, Bing satellite, Bing hybrid, like that. Different maps we have observed on different layers we have observed on the Wikimapia. So I hope you understood all these things. I hope you marked all these things in your textbook. And also we have done the next activities of locating our home on map. After opening the Wikimapia, we have done an activity of locating our home on map. So for that, we have opened the Wikimapia. After that, we locate our place by zooming the locations. We locate the particular place for marking our home. And also, we have done different steps. We have done in order to mark the home, we have clicked on that add place button. I hope you remember that those things. Okay, so these are things we have discussed, and also I have just introduced about the collaborative mapping. So today in this session we will be discussing more about collaborative mapping, and also one important topic, GIS, Geographical Information System. So before that, we will be moving to the textbook. So I hope you all have textbook with you. So you have to open the page number 79. You have to take that page number. Yes, this activity we have done before. And also we have just discussed about collaborative mapping. So once more I will be discussing that. What is this collaborative mapping? What all maps comes under collaborative mapping? Yeah, OpenStreetMap, Wikimapia, right? So collaborative mapping is the method of mapping an area using the data given by users. I hope you understood that. In Wikimapia, what we have done, we have located our home. So we have given the data. So by giving the data by users, we can locate different maps. So these maps are known as collaborative mapping. The content can be edited by anyone. Only an outline map will be prepared at first. Places and things are later added as the objects to this map. Subsequently, a map containing several information gets shaped due to the voluntary effort of lakhs of people. OpenStreetMap, Wikimapia and Google Maps are collaborative maps. The maps which we can edit or which we can add contents freely is known as the collaborative map. So these all are some of the examples of the collaborative maps. So I hope it is clear to all of you. Okay. So we studied how to open the Wikimapia. Digital maps. Map making is an area that has benefited a lot as a result of the advanced information and communication technology. Maps prepared using very complicated techniques can now be prepared more accurately and precisely using an appropriate software. They have many uses, such as including data from different areas at different layers in the same map, displaying facts related to several thematic maps, displaying the changes happening on the land surface, and so on. We discussed about different types of digital maps, which includes OpenStreetMap, Wikimapia, Google Map, like that. In this way, we have a software for making digital maps, in which we can add contents, we can add informations, we can edit informations, we can add different layers. You have learned in your social science class for what other purposes maps are used. I hope you learned. Or not for finding the places, but also we can use the maps for population analysis, watershed, for cultivation, that means related to the weather, related to population, related to the land, different types of lands. A lot of informations we will be getting from the maps. So have you seen the map of your panchayat? What if the maps give the total area of cultivated and the barren land are available? Maps with such data are very helpful for planning and implementation of the projects in panchayat. Did you notice, anyone notice the map of our panchayat? Someone maybe notice, someone not. In our panchayat map, it is basically related to the locations of the locations in panchayat, places which is located in the panchayat. We can add a lot of data, we can edit data in this type of maps. If we want to add more informations, if we want to add different locations, we can do with the help of a software. That software name is Geographical Information System. If we want to add informations, if we want to create a map, if we want to add different locations, if we want to mark that locations in a map, we can do these all things with the help of a software, and it is known as GIS or a Geographical Information System. It is a software that can record land surface information and positional information in different layers. They can collect, store digitally and analyze a lot of information. By using this QGIS, Geographical Information System, what we can do, we can record the land surface information. If we are taking a map of a panchayat, if we want to record the details of the specific land surface or the positional informations, or if we want to mark different places on the map, we can do by using this software. We can do it in different layers. I hope you studied about layers in GIMB. What is this layers? In GIMB, we will be having a layers panel window. What is that? In GIMB, while creating the pictures, while adding the pictures or adding text, we will be creating different layers so that we can edit independently. In the same way, in this map also, there are different layers in which we can add different locate places, add informations independently. Okay, so for that, a software will help us for doing that. It is known as a Geographical Information System. Different softwares, the example of this Geographical Information System is Quantum GIS, GRASS, ArcGIS. They all are well-known GIS applications. Here we will be using, in this chapter, we will be using QGIS or Quantum GIS. This Quantum GIS and GRASS are free software. Free software means, I hope you studied about free software in the first chapter. The software which we can edit, store, or we can move freely without any license. That's why they are known as the free software. Anyone can edit that software. Anyone can edit that source code of that software. So this Quantum GIS and the GRASS are those types of software. So next we will be moving, we will be studying about in detail about the Quantum GIS software. So we have discussed about collaborative mapping. We have discussed about geographical information system. I hope you understood what is this geographical information system. And next we will be moving to an activity 6.5, acquainting with tools. That means we will be familiarizing about this QGIS, quantum GIS software. And we will be doing different projects in that software. So for that, I'm going to open QGIS desktop in your computer. How we can do that? So for that, we have to take application, education. Here you can see QGIS desktop. So we will wait for it to come. Remaining portion of this chapter is all we are discussing about this QGIS software, that means quantum GIS. Yes, this is the software, this is the page of our software. We can close this. Here you can see a project. Here you can see a project. This project I have added from our school resource folder. Okay. Basically, throughout this chapter, we are discussing about this project only. This is a project based on a panchayat. Okay, so in our school resource folder, it is available. But I have given the one school resource folder previously when the academic year starts. In that school resource folder, this project will not be available. This project we have to download separately. So those who are having computer, those who want to do this project, this activity, I can post this folder, this file I can post in the Google Classroom so that others can access that. Okay, so I have downloaded this school project of panchayat, and we have to open this project in QGIS. Already it is opened here, but also I will be showing how we can open that. You can see here the menu project. From this menu we have to go to the option open. So you can see here in desktop I have take the location in desktop. This school resource folder is placed. When we click here, go to standard 10, and from standard 10 you can see a folder QGIS projects, and in QGIS projects you can see panchayat project. Okay, so this we have to open in the QGIS software. So already this is opened. So I hope you understood what are all the steps to open a project in QGIS. So this is the project. This is the map of a panchayat. This is the map of panchayat. You can see what all are here in this map. Schools are there, house, panchayat road, well, roads, different other roads, river, you can see river, plots you can see, and also boundary. Okay, so these all are the plots or the locations which we have marked in this panchayat map. So just we will be familiarizing about this map in this video. So for that we have to be keep in mind about certain tools. First one is of toggle editing. If you want to add any informations to this map, we can use the tool toggle editing and add feature. We have to use both these tools for adding the informations. And also next which we have to keep in mind is zoom. If you want to zoom, we can use that zoom to layer, zoom last, zoom next. If you want to, in this way also we can move, and we can by double clicking we can move the map. Okay, and also next option which tool which we are using, this one, open attribute table. open attribute table. It is basically used to see the details. If the school is marked here, if I want to see the details of that school, it will be in the attribute table. So that I will be showing. So these are some of the tools which we are using for doing the activity. So here you can see schools, house. So if you want to see this specifically, what we can do? If I am removing the tick mark of here, you can see the schools are removed. Again, I am clicking on the house. You can see houses are gone. Panchayat Road disappears. Well disappears. Roads. Plots disappears. Boundary also disappears. So here nothing is showing here. So next I am going to start from here. Boundary. First boundary came. Next is the plots. You can see different plots. Next, if I want to show river, you can see the river going through this panchayat. Roads. This red line mark the it is showing the roads. Well, you can see well here. Panchayat Road. Panchayat Road you can see. House. These all are the houses in that panchayat. And two school. You can see the school in square shape marked. You can see the school. So these all constitutes the map of a panchayat. So if I want to see the details of house in this panchayat, we can use the attribute table. So for that, select the option house. After that, go to open attribute table. You can see the details of the houses, the different houses, the name of the owners and their house number, roof, address, village, everything you can see here. In this way, we can add a lot of informations. We can add different locations in this map. So this is just an outline about the QGIS. In the textbook, you can see that activity, it is explaining in detail. After opening the QGIS window, you can see in this way. These all are some of the different options which we are using for doing the activity. Identifying the features, select features, open attribute table, measure line. So about these different options, we will be using these different tools in upcoming activities. So I will be explaining about that later. Okay, these two feature we will be using, this add feature and toggle editing. These two tools we are using for adding the informations. It is the next activity we are doing. So for adding the informations, we will be using this two, add feature and toggle editing. And open attribute table is used to see the details which we have stored in that map based on a particular location. Okay, the surface features of the earth and locational information are collected in a server in the form of maps and data. Geographical information technique is a information system is a technique developed to make necessary changes to this database, analyze them, classify them, and so on. In short, collects data related to geography in computer and make use of them as required. In this way, analytics found after a long search becomes available within minutes. That means by using this geographical information system, digitally we can store the map, we can add the informations, we can analyze them, classify them, we can collect a lot of information. So if we got a question, describe about the geographical information system, you can write these all steps. So here, what panchayat.qgs, a resource map named panchayat.qgs, this is placed in our school resource folder. We have to open from the project menu. I hope you understood how to do those steps. Different layers containing positional information about the panchayat in the layer box of the map. We already observed that this is the layers panel. different layers you can observe. One layer, school, house, panchayat, like the different layers you observe. When we untick, you can see the difference in the map. And after opening the attribute table, you can see the data of each layers. You can see here, this is the attributes window of different of showing different houses and its details. And this is about the Quantum GIS. It's a free software, first came out in 2009. Many versions are released later. The aim of this application is not to make maps alone. This software helps us to do many things such as to display maps, modify maps, create new ones, analyze the data available in the geographical domain, display the analysis results in the form of tables or maps as and required as so on. Different features we can do by using this with the help of this Quantum GIS. If you want to add a location, if you want to add a plot, if you want to add the information, if you want to edit the information, we can do by using this QGIS software. Okay, so these all things we will be discussing in this session. I hope it is clear to all of you. Okay, so what all things we have studied today? We have discussed about digital maps and also collaborative mapping. We also explained about that, and we have started a new topic, geographical information system, for adding the for editing or for creating the maps digitally. And we have the one example of this geographical information systems. It is software is QGIS desktop. We understood how to open QGIS application, education, QGIS desktop, and we familiarized about that software. So practice the activity. Those are having computers, others mark those in the textbook. If you have any doubt, we will be explaining it in the coming Google Meet. So see you in the next class. Thank you. Bye.